My name is Bella. I just wanted to talk about my job. I'm a phlebotomist, and I wanted to talk about what it's like to work for the day, how much you get paid, the best and worst parts, if you need schooling. So basically what a phlebotomist is you draw blood from people, you do venipuncture, which is basically inserting a needle into somebody. I work at a plasma center, so I work with blood reinfusion. There are also phlebotomists who draw blood and who send blood off to labs for testing at hospitals and whatnot, but I work at a plasma center. So what I do on the daily is I show up to work, put on a full coat, PPE, a face shield, everything like that, and I collect blood samples in, I'll show tubes on the screen here of what I collect. I also insert 20 gauge needles into people's arms right here. So I have a bruise right here from where I got poked, I guess. And sometimes you can give bruises to people, but that's not what a good phlebotomist does. So You insert a 20 gauge needle into somebody's arm after following like stages of procedures to clean the arm and whatnot, selecting a vein, and you connect them to a plasmapheresis machine, which spins the plasma out of your whole blood and gives you back your red blood cells. So that's basically what I do on a daily basis. I work for about 8 to 9 hours a day, which is pretty normal. The pay scale, it depends on if you're certified or not. So if you go into the job at a plasma center certified and you start in phlebotomy, at least in Idaho, you make $13.50 an hour starting. And if you are like me and you have no schooling, no certification, you have to move up to that. So I started at $12.50 and I started just learning how to do phlebotomy from people that have worked there. So after about a month or two, you can get up to $13.50 and you get your yearly raises, whatnot. So that's pretty standard pay for most phlebotomists, even if you're working at a hospital. So that is kind of that. I did not need any school to go into this job. They just looked for more of your personality traits, like if you're willing to learn, if you're willing to work with blood and plasma and work with people's veins and touching people all day, it's kind of either for you or it's not. So you kind of have to try it out to see if it's for you or not. But I'd say for me, I had no idea going into it that it's what I wanted to do. But after actually doing it, I found out that it's something that I really like, and you can keep growing and keep learning new things and advance and whatnot. So I think it's a really good job if you just give it a chance. I'd say what I like about the job, it's really tedious. You have to be really careful and you gain people's trust. So I see people about twice a week is when people can come in and donate plasma. So I see the same people usually every week, and you can gain trust with donors and they can trust you or not, and you can just improve, and they can see that. And then there are people that really like the way that you do things or that don't, and you can form really good relationships with donors. And that's one thing that I really like about that job, is you can learn a lot and about people, and it's really a personal job if you want it to be, or if you want a level of disconnect, you don't necessarily have to be friendly with everybody. And it's kind of you kind of pick how personal you are with people, and it's pretty awesome in that way. It's not like service where you're expected to be really friendly with everybody. It's kind of case by case if you like the donor or not, whatever. You can make it quick or you can make it go longer, but it's generally a pretty fast-paced job, which I also like. So if you're into that, like running around all day and being on your feet and working with a bunch of people, it's really good for that. But on the side of what I don't like. I would say some donors can be a little kind of weird, or they have tricky veins, and you kind of could get in a rut if you aren't able to stick somebody. Call it sticking. If you're not able to stick somebody, you could kind of get in a rut, and then all the entire day could just go in a downward spiral of giving people hematomas, or not allowing them to donate because you wore out all of your possibilities. Say one arm, like this arm, I got a bruise here. If it swole up into a hematoma and there was a big collection of blood under the skin, you have to switch to this arm. And if the vein on this arm didn't work, then you are out of possibilities and they can't donate for the day. So that can get kind of defeating if you do that to a bunch of people. And then you also lose some of that trust. But to get out of a rut like that, you really have to just either move around and take a break, or like just wash your hands, take a little break from what you're doing and kind of step back into it with a new, okay, I'm gonna do good now. And then it can kind of even out if you try and take a fresh start after something bad happens. But that's one bad thing, is you can kind of get into a rut really easily. And the reverse of that, you can get into a really good place very easily. So there's the ups and downs of that. And so I just wanted to share what it's like to be a phlebotomist and a couple details about the job that I do. So let me know if you have any questions. I'd like to answer some of those with what I know. So bye.